Today's adventure is collaborative art for my school. Last year, I did a collaborative art piece for my class, and my principal, who is the nicest person on the planet, really loved it. And so this year, we're going bigger, and we're having every student and every staff member in the school participate. Every person makes 3 buildings, a large, a medium, and a small, and they make some fireworks, and I'm going to put them all together and make a collaborative art piece in the lobby of our school. I'm gonna try and do a time lapse, which I have never really done. Like, I've done long video clips and then sped them up, but this is actually like a setting on the GoPro, and I hope I'm doing it right. If not, we won't have a time lapse. But I will do a time lapse of me building it. I'll probably have to build it over the course of 2 days. So today my goal is the fireworks. And if I can get through the fireworks and do the buildings, awesome. And if not, then I'll just come back another day to do the buildings. We're still on winter break, so no one's here. And I'm hoping to make a lot of progress. I'm gonna show you the one I did from last year. It's obviously much smaller than the one we're gonna do this year because this is only one class. And our school is a K-8, and there is one class per grade. So that's 9 classes, and the one I'm gonna show you is only one class worth. So the biggest buildings are in the front, the smallest ones are in the back, and then the fireworks are up above. So we'll see how it goes when I do one for the whole school. So I've got 3 different stacks of fireworks. Depending on the kind of paint that each group made. It has nothing to do with that. It's just, that's the bag we used. But I'm gonna start with these more faded ones that used a different type of paint as my background, because it'll look like they're further away. And I'm gonna use liquid glue to glue them onto the backdrop. I've used all the fireworks that our school made, and I have some blank spots. So I am gonna make some more fireworks. I don't know what time it is, but I think I have time to at least make the fireworks. And then I probably won't have time to put them up today, but I think I don't need a ton more. I'll show you what I've got so far. So that up there is the firework sky, firework sky, firework sky, firework, oop. Then I've got some black spots there. The fireworks go behind the TV, which is good, but I still need some more up there. And then this section, I expected to be able to come back and fill it in, and I don't have enough to come back and fill it in. So I need some more fireworks here, there, there, and right over there. So I will make some more fireworks before I leave. And that will be the end of day one, and I'll come back and do the buildings another day. I've made some additional fireworks, and when they dry, I will cut them out and add them to the display, which they're too wet to do today. So that is truly the end of day one. Okay, day two. It's a very rainy day outside. It's a good day to be inside. My parents are supposed to be driving home today, but instead it's getting really snowy on their route, so they are not driving home today, but I still need to come in and do this. So I am going to finish the fireworks, and I wanted to show you what the fireworks were like, and then I'll show you the buildings, and then I'll put up the buildings, and I'm hoping I can finish it today. The fireworks can be any size, and essentially we're just gonna cut them out into circles, and then we'll put those circles up on the wall. But my job now, since I didn't have enough fireworks, is to cut these extras out so that I can put them up before I move on to the buildings. Okay, so the fireworks are done. There's a couple spots that aren't quite as overlappy. There's a couple gaps that I don't love, so I'm gonna move on to the buildings, and if when it's all done, I feel like it needs a couple more fireworks, I will make a couple more fireworks. But right now I feel like I'm pretty much done with the fireworks. Here, take a look. lighting in here is pretty terrible. So sorry, it's the best that I can do. But you can kind of see what it looks like. And now for step two, which is really like maybe step 17, but we're just gonna go with step two. Fireworks are step one and buildings are step two. Let me show you the buildings. Okay, so there are three different sizes of buildings, and the smallest buildings go in the back. Each kiddo was given a piece of paper, which I probably should have done cardstock, because then I wouldn't have to worry about it like getting warped with liquid glue. Because I'm gonna try it with glue sticks to avoid getting warped, and I don't know that that's gonna work. So I may have to just do the liquid glue, and it'll get kind of warped, and that'll be what it is. If I had done cardstock, it would have been better. But every kid got a piece of paper with three rectangles on it. This is the size of one rectangle. Now, that didn't mean every building had to be a rectangle. And they could do like different shapes as long as it fit inside the rectangle. And some kiddos definitely did different shapes. And then some of our teachers and our staff members did like really phenomenal buildings. Look at that, that's amazing. So that was our smallest one. Then this is another one, our principal did that one. That's the medium size. And then the largest size is really large. So I'm gonna start with the smallest in the back, and hopefully I'll get through all the buildings today. But now that I'm looking at the stack, I'm thinking there's no way I'm finishing this today. So we'll see. Update. So the small buildings are done. Let's take a look at it. That took two, so all of the small buildings took two glue sticks and a little bit more. So I'm actually really happy because the glue stick is totally working and I have plenty of glue to get the project done. So glue stick for the win. Now I'm gonna start with the medium sized buildings. All right, this is going pretty quickly. I am now done with the medium sized buildings. The medium sized buildings took four-ish glue sticks, and so you can see the progress that I've made. The hardest part about this is trying to estimate how much space it's gonna take. So now that I only have the big ones left, I really wanna make sure I'm filling up the remainder of the black. And so I think I'm gonna spread them further apart and hope that that doesn't ruin things in the end. So here we go. Here's the final step, big buildings. Okay, so I'm done. And by done, I mean I'm done for today. I've put up all of the fireworks and all of the buildings. I do feel like I need to do something to like finish it off, but let me show you what it looks like right now. I may just leave it as it is, but I do feel like, I don't know, something on the bottom, or I don't know, I'm not sure, but I'm really happy with how it turned out. It was so fun to see the individual personalities of our school community, because the students did it, the teachers, the aides, the office staff, the enrichment teachers, like everybody participated, and it is so neat to see their personalities shine through. I love collaborative art projects because it's so much about the community and not about the individual artists. And I do think when the kids come back from break and they see this app and the teachers, I think they're going to like it. I hope they do. Okay, day three. I've decided, I went home last night, looked at the pictures that I took, and really feel like it needs something to kind of finish the bottom. So we're gonna do two things. I made a cobblestone road, and by I mean I used free labor of my mom and Charlie and I. We made cobblestone roadways, so we're gonna see how much, if we did enough or not. And then I used my Cricut to make letters for a Bible verse that we'll also put there. I'm not really sure how it's gonna go, but my dad's here to help me out. So we'll see, and hopefully this will truly be the end of it. It is done.
except for one letter. We have to bring back one letter. But it's done. It was a huge help to have my dad here. Take a look at the mostly finished product, which I will show it again to you when I put the last G on there.
It just needs the G right there. Charlie came in clutch, brought the ladder. My dad, awesome, big help. Yay. I love it. So we added all the cobblestone and like a fountain and some shrubs and trees, a little bit of a park over there to fill up some of it so it has like a more finished bottom, which I'm really, really happy with how that part turned out. I'm so happy.
It is finally, finally done.
This is from the book of Matthew, and it says, "A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. In the same way, let your light shine before others so they may see your good works and give glory to God in heaven." All right, and now I just want to show you like the close-ups of some of this. It is so neat.
Thanks for watching.